Welcome to our first interview series in NYALI, Mombasa. And today we are privileged to have the honor of our first Airbnb tour in NYALI. And I will introduce her in a few. She has a very inspiring story of how she started the business. And she's gonna tell us the insights of the business in Mombasa, NYALI area. And hey, I mean, we can learn a thing or two, right? So let's go. So, Rachel, welcome to our first interview.
Thank you so much.
We're so honored to have you. And we just finished shooting the amazing story that you have here. So I want to know a brief introduction of how you're working, how the business is. So first, how did you get to
Okay, I got into the business in September. It's been a journey of almost
September last year. So you're talking about CC, what the rest talking about Corona, and your mind is all about investing, right?
Yes.
Great. And how's been the journey so far?
The journey has been great. I can't complain. Definitely it was something I ventured to. It was new to me as well. But I ventured to it with all my heart and I've tried to give it my all. And that's why this one. I can't wait.
Fantastic. I remember the first time I was here, we were about the decoration of space. And although we never got to do the job, but I'm just amazed at how you did it, how that push to start was so amazing. And I would love to know, I read your story at the end of the day. Just a brief story of before this, what were you doing and what inspired you to get into this space? There must be some very interesting this
So, previously, I was working in a media house. I've worked in media for 3 years. And with all the corona time and everything, I was doing advertising. It was basically sales. So things were not working out. I felt like it was not working out. Business was slow. You paid on commission. You don't, at some point you get, you don't even have money to sustain yourself. And starting an Airbnb was an idea I had for the longest time. And I was just like, why not try it out? It is not that, and then what will happen? What's the worst that can happen? Let me just try out and see how things go. If it doesn't work out, I
know.
But yeah, but let me just try it because it's something that has already been changed.
So right now, so far, do you feel like you can go back to yourself? Because I mean, you're not here every day, you're not running every day. Do you still feel like you can go back there to your job work? It's now it's 20 minutes, it's forever.
Okay, definitely sometimes you feel, you wake up and you feel like maybe employment is better, 9 to 5 is better. But to be honest, I don't think I'll be going back to that. I just want to invest more and more. I just want to do more projects. Probably run a couple of houses. My target is 10 this year.
Wow, yes. Man,
so,
that's nice.
Yeah, so I'll really try. I'll give myself that push and see what happens.
Great. And so what made you choose this location? I mean, it's a very nice view. It's a 3-bedroom. What made you choose this location? Hey, I want a 3-bedroom, villa, room.
Actually, the first time I came to know this apartment, I did my birthday here last year.
Oh, great.
Yes.
So you were first client?
Yes, I was first a client.
Okay.
And then I was like, I had already started, I was 19. So when I did my birthday here, I was like, this is it. This is what I want. Yes. And I said, I'm good for this. And I'm sure I did good for this. Yeah.
Wow. So what's your ideal client in such a space? This space?
Okay, my target market is families, business people whom have really supported me because most of my clients are business people and passionate about local. Those are my big clientele and most of my clients are actually repeat clients. That's why I've survived since I started. Yes, I've had a lot of repeat business and a lot of referrals coming here.
Yeah, because going forward, are you still going to invest in three bedrooms around Nyali? Or are you going to expand?
I will expand to Shanzu, Niani, Mabuli. I want to try and expand, and I want to do three bedrooms. I'll combine, I'll do two bedrooms, one bedroom, studio. I'll try and expand so that I can offer solution for everyone. You don't have to lock out the people because they can't afford that three bedrooms.
Amazing. Does that mean that you're going to do this business solely, or is this a business that can light solely and invest in not have something else
Okay, not really, because this is something that mostly depends when you have clients at all. So you can't tell your client, I have other things going on in my life, I have other projects I'm still working on. So no, it is not the only thing that I am doing.
So you cannot advise anyone to have it as the only business that's bringing in.
I wouldn't advise that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And finally, what would you advise anyone who wants to get into the field? And also, you guys know, it's a huge market. In fact, I had a man who told me how it's overcrowded, especially in the past, and in the area. So, what would you advise about three things you guys have to consider for the
community? Just follow your heart. Be confident and be sure that you can do it. You really need yourself so much. And talk to people. Money comes from people. So be good at people and you'll get your money.
Fantastic. Thank you very much for your time and being the first guest in our interview series. And I hope to be part of the journey to see you grow from one to 10 this year and even more. Shooting those apartment tours as well for the rest of the videos. Hey, the rest is history.